Clerk Colvill and his lusty dame were walking in the garden green, a belt around her stately waist, which cost Clerk Colvill £15. Oh, promise me, no Clerk Colvill, or it will cost ye muckle strife. Ride never by the wells of slain, if he would live and brook your life. No speak nae mair, my lusty dame, no speak nae mair o' that to me. Did I ne'er see a fair woman, but I would sin wi' her body. He's ta'en leave o' his gay lady, not minding what his lady said, and he's rode by the wells of slain, where washing was a bonny maid. Wash on, my bonny maid, that wash sae clean your sark o' silk, and weel for you, fair gentlemen, your body whiter than the milk. He's ta'en her by the milk-white hand, he's ta'en her by the sleeve sae green, and he's forgotten his gay lady, and he's awa' with a fair maiden. Then out loud cried Clerk Colvill, "Oh, my head, it pains me, sir." "Then take a knife," the maiden said, "and frame a sark you'll cut a share." Out he has ta'en his little penknife, and fray her sark he's cut a share. She's tied it round his wayward face, but aye his head it ached mair. Then Luda cried the Clerk Colvill, "Oh, Sarah, Sarah aches my head, and Sarah, Sarah ever will," the maiden cries, "till you be dead." Thinking to stick her where she stood, he then drew out his trusty blade, but she was vanished tae a fish, and swam far off a fair mermaid. He's mounted on his berry brown steed, and dowie dowie raid he hame, and heavily, heavily lighted doon, to his lady's bower he came. "My lusty lady, lay me doon, oh, mither, see my bed is made. Oh, brither, take my sword and spear, for I have seen the false mermaid."